everybody. Welcome to Center for Spiritual Living Parker. I am Senior Minister Reverend Stephanie Stewart, and it is our joy to be a place of love and celebration where we are devoted to living and teaching the spiritual life. How are you doing today?
Great.
All right, excellent, excellent. It's good to see your faces. All your masks. All your masks. Felina, are you okay? Oh, you're about to fall over back there. Stay on your feet, girl. Stay on your feet. We have a new camera operator today. Joining me on public today is, let's see, who's doing everything today? I don't even know. Let's see, Jeanette Bennis, and who's doing announcements? Is it Shirley? Shirley Lane is joining us on pulpit today, so thank you. And this is our latest iteration of the van. Who do we have on keys today?
Sajowski.
Tony Sajowski.
Yes.
I'm going to remind everybody next week, I will not be here. Reverend Rabbit will be here. Reverend Rabbit is sometimes late.
Is that next week or next week?
No, that's next week, isn't it? Isn't it next week? I don't know, the 31st. Isn't that next week?
No,
today's only the 17th.
Yeah.
It's been a rough weekend. So on the 31st, Reverend Rabbit will be joining us, and they are sometimes late. But make sure you dress up for the 31st. I'm just reminding you to dress up for the 31st. So that will be the 31st.
Wow.
It's been a long week, I'm sorry. So will you all join me in a moment of prayer, please? So here now, this place and time, I know that God is, that Spirit is, all around us and within us, expressing as each of us in our music, in our children, and in His service. I know we are all here by divine appointment, but the message today has something in it for each of us, including myself. And I know that we are each a blessing, and that we are each blessed. And so I rejoice in today, and I am grateful for today and everyone here, and everyone who receives this message, receives this service. Anchor this with me by saying, and so it is.
Between yourself and your brother or sister.
no difference when you come from the heart. Take in another deep breath and just let that settle in deeper into your heart.
Inescapable network
of mutuality, mired into a single garment of destiny. Whatever affects one destiny affects all indirectly. And from our founder, Dr. Ernest Holmes, the unity of good is a revelation of the greatest importance, for it teaches us that we are one with the whole and one with each other. The fatherhood of God and the actual brotherhood of man will be made apparent on earth to the degree that man realizes true unity.
How we doing?
Still kind of in shock because I'm only 17. I'm losing weeks, not days, weeks.
I'm gaining weeks, is that what it is?
Yeah. I'm gaining weeks. So, if you go back to your co-creation process, you co-created a minister that would bring unity. Do you recall that?
Yes.
I want to bring that up very briefly, because that's what you've entrusted me with. And I take that very seriously. I take everything with this community very seriously. I love this community a great deal. I've only been here 3 months now. And, well, I've said this repeatedly, you've stolen my heart. You've stolen my heart. So when I said this had been a rough week, I'm going to talk about that today. So today's talk is called Me is Greater Than Me, and I'm not really sure what to think about it. I've basically been talking about this all month. And if this week has been any indication, what I've been talking about has been kind of difficult to internalize. I've been presented with a lot of people's fear this week. It started at the beginning of the week, and it's just kind of steamrolled from there. A lot of people's fear has come to visit me. And as with all things, I've studied it pretty closely to see how much of it was mine. Some of it is. Some of it definitely is. I think a lot of it's just exhaustion. We're all tired of COVID. I've been saying for a few weeks now that we're not like really well prepared to welcome people. That love is not enough. That we have to have humility to examine our biases, listen to learn, to have courage. Evidently, though, you thought I just meant if a stranger walked in. And I guess I said that, right? I thought that. Am I a little too tall? I thought, you know, it was just the stranger too, that when they came in, maybe we weren't quite ready. I learned a little differently this week. This week I learned that we aren't actually really well prepared to welcome one another. To welcome the vaccinated and the unvaccinated in our midst. We are so scared we aren't prepared to be a we, even with the people that we've been a we with for years. And that's too bad. It breaks my heart, actually. I can only encourage people to examine their biases. I can't force it, I won't force it. Leadership in this center won't take a side, not as long as I'm in charge. Leadership will take a stance that all are welcome here, no matter their vaccination status. There may be some of you folks that don't like that, and I understand. And you may think to perhaps call Laura, but I hope that you would come and talk to me instead, because I'm the one that said that. I'm the leadership here. I'm the one saying that everybody's welcome. That's not to say that the board doesn't agree, but I'm the one saying it right now. Because there is great fear in this congregation. You've been through a great deal together. And there is a great deal more to go through. There's always going to be something in life that we can let bring us together or drive us apart. It's all a matter of choices. A wedge from within could wreck this community fairly easily. And if you're sitting there thinking, well, it's their fault if they just do this, or if you're sitting there thinking, well, it's their fault if they just leave me alone, please understand that's part of the problem. There's no other here. There's no other here. There is only our spiritual siblings. If we're letting vaccine status be a wedge, we'll always be able to find a wedge. I'm not saying don't do things to be safe. Look, I'm scared too. My mother is fully vaccinated and will get her booster next week, and she also only has 20% of her lung capacity. I could bring it home to her. And if she gets sick, even vaccinated, with only 20% of her lung capacity, she'll die. But I'm not going to let it be a wedge in this community that I love. Why? Because we is greater than me. I will go further with all of you than I will go by myself. I will go further with all of you than I will go by myself. There is an African life philosophy called Ubuntu. Ubuntu. U-B-U-N-T-U. Ubuntu. It essentially means I am because we are. I am because we are. Now, this can be very challenging for Americans to grasp. We're all about rugged individualism, right? And this is distinctly African. It's found throughout Southern African cultures. Archbishop Desmond Tutu described it this way. He said, "A person with Ubuntu is open and available to others, affirming of others, does not feel threatened that others are able and good, based from proper self-assurance that comes from knowing that he or she belongs in a greater whole and is diminished when others are humiliated or diminished when others are tortured or oppressed." He went on to say, "I am a human because I belong, I participate, I share. I belong, I participate, I share." Not I think, therefore I am, but I belong, I participate, I share. I am human because of others. Not because I am, but because of others. Individuals are uplifted because of group support. Individuals are because they belong to a group. This is incredibly important because the stronger the me, the stronger the we. The stronger the me, the stronger the we. If we belittle or humiliate one part of the group, we weaken the we. That is not a good thing. are stories from some African tribes where they take someone who has done something wrong, and they take them into the center of the village, and everyone surrounds them. And they tell them every good and wonderful thing that they've ever done in their life, believing that their mistakes are actually cries for help, and that being reminded of all the good that they've done will connect them with their higher nature. The strengthening of the me strengthens the we. Can you see why this is so important? Can you see why it's so important right here, right now? There are centers closing all during the pandemic. We could tear each other apart, or we could practice Ubuntu. I am because we are. There are no others here. There are only our spiritual siblings. We've talked about compassion and forgiveness and grace. We could practice that here amongst ourselves. We don't just have to take it home and use it at work or forget about it entirely. We deserve it here amongst ourselves, don't we? Are we each worthy of compassion, forgiveness, and grace? If you're feeling you aren't worthy of compassion and forgiveness and grace, let me tell you, you're wrong. Let's put you in the middle of a circle and tell you all the good things you've done here at this center so you can remember that you're worthy. How about maintaining a positive attitude and recognizing we have shared concerns? Ubuntu lives in shared concerns. Do you think there are shared concerns here? Shared concerns lead to common ground. And common ground reminds us that there are no others here. There are only our spiritual siblings. Most of all, Ubuntu is about understanding that we are all bound together. Now, we don't have to be bound together here as CSL Parker. We could just as easily break apart. But we are still bound together in our humanity, and that is inescapable. This we is greater than just me. Think about it this way. Think about a puzzle. A puzzle is full of pieces, right? They're all different shapes. Some of them are a little squiggly and edges and corners, and they all eventually fit together though, right? Well, what if we don't let some of them in? No, the blues can't go in, the corners can't go in. You got a funny squiggly, you can't go in. Then our picture is incomplete. We have to let those pieces into their proper spots to get our picture complete. That is Ubuntu. I am because we are. Our spiritual practices take us to this place of understanding. Ubuntu isn't an intellectual concept to grasp and work with. It's something to understand and live from. What spiritual practice helps you grasp wholeness, and especially oneness? For me, it's meditation. There is something in that stillness that reminds me that we are all one. Whether I'm doing walking or sitting meditation, there's something in knowing that stillness underlying all the noise in my head. is present everywhere all the time, that it's accessible to everyone at any moment. It's a field that reminds me of oneness. Prayer is another spiritual practice that helps me grasp wholeness and especially oneness. The first two steps of prayer of spiritual mind treatment are specifically designed to take us to a place of oneness and wholeness. Are you engaging in spiritual practices on a regular basis? Are you engaging in them to grow? Or to say that you did them for the day? I am at times guilty of the latter. Engaging in spiritual practices on a regular basis to legitimately grow can be very scary sometimes. It can lead to a pattern of behavior where we're doing the practices but not engaging in them. Doing them gets to get them done. Doing them gets them done. And there certainly is a benefit to be had from that. But engaging in them, pouring yourself into them, and having something new poured back out, that obviously gives you the most benefit. It's what gives us that glimpse, that moment of oneness that makes the statement, "We is greater than me," ring so true. So we're each a piece of this puzzle that is Center for Spiritual Living Parker. But from what I've experienced this week, it seems like we don't want all our pieces. And I'm struggling to understand that. We can't be without one another. We don't exist without all our pieces. The puzzle is incomplete. If we can grasp Ubuntu, this concept of I am because we are, then we can make sure our puzzle stays complete. Again, I know it's challenging because it's so foreign. We're used to me first. We're used to, I think, therefore I am. But Ubuntu is, I am because you are, because we are. There is no other. There is only we. We go further together. We go further when we are we, not me and them, not us and them, not some of us, but not them. We. We is greater than me. This is hard. Because we're human. And I think this is especially hard because we're American. As Americans, we're not equipped for this. We're not equipped for me is greater than me. We're equipped for me first, and that's too bad. We're not equipped for Ubuntu. We're equipped for shame and blame, and that's too bad too. I have to stretch. I have to grow. We have to reach for me is greater than me. We have to reach for Ubuntu. And that's not so bad. It's a darn good thing. Growth is what we can expect. But I don't mean our numbers here at the Center for Spiritual Living Parker, although that could happen too. I mean growth in our hearts. pose that lets all the pieces into the puzzle. We have to decide, I guess, do we want to let all the pieces into the puzzle? Or do we want to throw the puzzle out? I'm not willing to let that happen without a fight. It's been a week, friends. And I love you. So I'm going to do something different. I don't generally give assignments, but I'm going to this week. All of you out there are either vaccinated or unvaccinated. I don't know who's which, and it's none of my business. I don't prefer to know. You probably know someone who is on the opposite side of the equation from you, though. Your assignment this week is to make them part of the puzzle again in your heart. Not in your living room. In your heart. Engage in your spiritual practices. Call a practitioner if you need help. Call me if you need help. There are no others here. There are only our spiritual siblings. Ubuntu. I am because we are. Will you pray with me? I center myself here now, right here now, knowing that God is, that Spirit is, within me and all around me, within us and all around us, is the one ever-loving, all-knowing, ever-flowing one. I know I am a part of it, and it is all of me. I know that it's true for me, and it's true for everyone here. We are a part of it. We are each a part of God, and it is all of each and every one of us. And so what I know for this congregation is unity, because that is what I have been entrusted with. And what I know for this congregation is love, because that is what I have been entrusted with. And that is what God entrusts us with. Place is such a blessing, and I rejoice in it. Every day I rejoice in it. Every day my alarm goes off and it says, pray for Parker. And every day my prayer is the same. Every day I say, please guide me to be the minister these people need me to be. And I know. So I say yes to that. I say yes to this divine center for spiritual living. I say yes to what we are and what we are becoming. And I am grateful. I'm grateful for everyone here today and everyone who hears this message, everyone who receives this message into their hearts and into their minds. So I let this go. I let it go knowing that it's already being done in the heart and the mind of that moment. Heart and the mind of God who says, only says yes. Who only says yes. Please anchor this now with me by saying, and so it is.
You guys that we do have that pre-service meditation going on every Sunday?
Is it on?
Can you hear me now?
I hear him with that.
I did. Can you hear me now?
It's on mute.
I tried both settings.
Yeah.
Hello?
The light is.
Hello?
You see?
It's on, okay. It's on loud. Hello? Hello, hello? Can you hear me? Yes?
Hear yourself.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, I hear you.
I want them to hear me, so I'm coming closer. All right. I just wanted to remind everyone that every Sunday, 9:30 in the morning, is our pre-service meditation. So that is up and running. We want your beautiful faces before to be on meditation, so before we actually start the service. So that is a wonderful, wonderful thing. Please come join us, okay? We have that every Sunday. And then our second announcement is, I just want to remind everyone again that there's still room for our classes. We have two classes starting next week. The Change Your Life, Change Your Thinking, Change Your Life by Ernest Holmes. That is a great class. That is a CSL certificated class. And it's a wonderful class because we are going to be working on science of mind fundamentals here. And you know how the science of mind fundamentals are really important? For what? For increasing, for improving our relationships, our health, and our wealth. So it is a very, very good class to attend. For five sessions, starting Tuesday next week, from 6:30 to 8:30 via Zoom. All right? Now, the second class is also a wonderful class. It is entitled, what is it called? Getting always confused of how you say that. Oh, Full Cup, Thirsty Spirit. So that too, from the title alone, is a very exciting class, guys. If you are super, super busy in your life and you want to try to bridge and make a connection between your inner and outer lives, this is a great class for you because you're going to learn to reconnect those two things together and learn to prioritize what really is joyful and really what makes, you know, meaning into you in your life. So attend that class. And that is a love offering class for four sessions, only 1 hour. It's going to start not next week, but the week after on a Thursday from 6:30 to 7:30. Love donation doesn't cost a whole lot, but you're going to learn a lot. So I really recommend that two classes. And of course, that is actually being offered by our own Reverend Stephanie. So you know it's going to be a wonderful class. And then the one thing I wanted to announce to everyone is that a portion of your wonderful donation actually goes to this wildlife sanctuary. Anybody been there to the wildlife sanctuary? So isn't that a great place? That is a great place. Why? Okay, because your donation could actually help us, you know, help them actually put together animals, large animals, wherein their previous owners can no longer take care of them. So the sanctuary actually brings them in-house, takes care of them, otherwise they could be euthanized. And it's also a wonderful environment for these large predators because I think it's like, 10,000 acres? So it's huge. So after they've been taken care of, they can really roam around in the wild and be happy. So really, your donation does make a big difference, that I'm glad that we're able to do this. And last, but very, very important announcement, it has been brought to my attention, and it's Lori Smith's birthday!
Benediction real quick. Let's just do a quick prayer.
Okay.
So I'm just grateful for everyone who's been here today. I'm grateful for the music. I'm grateful for our youth. I know that we all travel home in absolute safety and have a wonderful week. And so it is.
We're a thousand miles from comfort. We have traveled land and sea. But as long as you are with me, there's no place I'd rather be.
Take it, it's a shot in the dark.
When I am with you, there's no place I'd rather be.